Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I would like you all to please turn off your cellular devices and or, you know, any electronics that can interrupt this wonderful presentation that we will have. If not, you won't really learn anything. But anyway, I'm Deja Young. My major is media production, minor in theater.
Hi, my name is Monica. I'm a junior here, and my major is social work and Spanish.
Hi guys, my name is Anissa Hill. I'm a senior, and my major is supply chain.
Hi, I'm Casey Wilcher. I'm a second year dietetics student. Let's go.
My name is Matt Kinesi. I'm a junior here, and I am studying individualized studies with a focus in pre-physical therapy.
And I'm Katie. I'm a third year art major with the art education program here at BGSU. I've been working a lot in the art building and I noticed that we needed some major renovations. So our topic is renovating the art building and what equipment that we need to make it the perfect art building for our students here at BGSU.
Ew, that stinks. Let's go. In 1948, it was proposed for this building to be built, and in 1950, it took 2 years until it was finally opened in 1950.
Hey everyone, these stalls are Monica-sized! Really? What tells you that?
Supposedly, a rumor in the 1940s says this entire building started off as an elementary school. You can kind of see that in the doors, in some of these boards, and definitely in these very small lockers. In 1960, an addition was approved. 10 years later, after it was built, it included new lecture halls, new facilities for drawing, painting, sculpturing, design, and jewelry making. Two new classrooms were also implemented as a part of this renovation in 1960.
Oh, hey there. Have you ever wanted to draw or paint? I mean, that's wrong. Just saying. Do you want to learn more? I think you want to learn. You want to learn more? I see you in the bag. I know you want to learn more. Okay. Well, let's go.
Okay guys, now we're going to talk about 2D. 2D consists of paintings and drawings. In order to make the renovations better for these rooms, we need better chairs, better easels, and more room for sinks.
In order to raise or lower any of the chairs that we currently have, we have to make this horrible, disgusting noise.
In a room of about 20 to 25 students, there are only 2 sinks. You can imagine the traffic that comes from this.
In order to keep our sinks running smoothly, we have to plunge them kind of often, and it gets really annoying.
So in order to make this better, we propose getting trough style sinks, for each room in order to minimize traffic. Also, easels. The easels in each room are pretty old. In order to make that better, we just want to get better easels. An easel is about $150. This includes large easels, which roll, which is better for the artist. And also, we want to get better chairs. Rolling chairs, preferably for the artist to make their painting experience better. Rolling chairs are, on average, are about $50. So in conclusion, we want to make sure that we have better sinks, better easels, and better chairs in order to make the painting experience better for our students.
Okay, so my name's Carly. I'm a junior in art education with a specialization in 2D painting and drawing. And I think what I would benefit from, as well as others, would be more technological resources as well as like better ones. Cameras, like a better variety, more projectors for both students and teachers. Also accessible maybe on weekends. I think it's probably the best decision because that benefits all the specializations, including 2D, 3D, 4D. That's probably it.
My name is Megan Harnish. I am a 2D art education major. I'm a sophomore. And I definitely think we need either new tabarets or like major cleanup of them because they're disgusting and hard. A lot of them are hard to move. The wheels on them aren't really working anymore. And then I definitely think even more tabarets, because a lot of times like I'll come into class and like have to like really scope out the room for one, and that's not really that fun either. Honestly, having another sink in here would be really nice, I think, especially with like how crappy and disgusting they are, if not new sinks of the ones that are already in here too. The easels are kind of gross too, like they just don't really move the way you want them to. Some of them are broken too, so I mean that's not that great.
Do you have to come in here at separate times to know that like an easel like this would be open, or do you just never?
There's always extra easels like when I do come for class, but sometimes I have to like search around and like play with them to find one that like I actually want to sit with for a couple hours during class, and even like outside of class too, like today for example. Rooms like, and especially in like next door in the figure drawing room, I don't remember off the top of my head, but it's like whenever we're in class, there's just like so much weird noise, and I'm like, I think I'm gonna get abducted by an alien, or like something as bad is going to happen. But like, yeah, it's just kind of, you always hear really weird things, and I don't know if it's from other classes or just the building itself.
Talking about 3D art, huh? I'm feeling pretty 3D. So, next, let's take a look at 3D things. But it's time. Let's go.
Hey
All right, so we're here in the clay studio. As you can see, we have pieces finished by students up on these shelves. And the biggest complaint we received from students and faculty alike was the fact that the studio is very crowded. As you can see, there's a lot of pieces for not a lot of shelf space. This leads to people's projects being destroyed when someone inadvertently bumps one and knocks it down.
Hi, my name is Sarah Caudill, and I am a BFA major. 3D studies in ceramics is my focus, and I'm a senior. I don't know if I said that, sorry. All the equipment in the ceramics studio, I feel like, is pretty okay. We're getting a new salt kiln next year, which is pretty awesome, so that's going to be a really good upgrade to the studio. I think a couple of our kilns could probably use a little more renovation. We use them all the time, and bricks fall apart over time, so if we can get that worked out, I'd be happy. And then the sculpture studio has been great since they did all the renovations over there. The wood shop looks amazing now. And I'm trying to think of what other studios. Metals, I think, recently got a couple upgrades. I don't know, but I always think it's good to just make sure that everything's new and good for all the students to use, because we use the facilities all the time. So the more up to date we are, I think it's better for all the students. That way we can make sure that we're competitive enough when we leave here, and we have all the updated equipment that we would be using outside of here.
Hey guys, are you thirsty for some, I don't know, interviews? We're grabbing a refresher to propose this to long-term professors and a safety technician. Let's go.
Gordon Ricketts, I'm a senior lecturer in the School of Art. Currently, I'm the intern director of Chapman Learning Community and the academic affairs coordinator for residential learning communities.
Earlier, you briefly stated that the degree is now considered a studio degree, but before that, you mainly teach 2D classes?
Yeah, I would be, they would not have me teaching sculpture.
Okay.
If they sent me to a ceramic studio, I would have clay all over the room, and if they sent me to the glass studio, I would probably burn people, and so.
Oh.
Yeah, so.
Lovely. In the classrooms that you've taught, what would you say you would like to see different? As far as equipment, the class size.
Yeah, I want a chalkboard. It's like, you know,
he wants
like
a chalkboard,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, I'm just like, can you please get me a chalkboard, something to write on, you know? But I think that you know, I would be teaching primarily up in there are three studios up on the second floor, a painting studio, a figure drawing studio, and a sort of a general drawing. Drawing right. Studio, and then the foundations are down in the hallway downstairs, 1102, 3, 4, 5, 6 down in that area. The classrooms that I mean, they've made some tentative they're always doing small things. I think upstairs, if I were to start with the studio spaces upstairs, certainly the drawing studio could use chalkboards. Or wait, or some place to write on the board, some way to when you're giving a lecture or talking with people, to draw a diagram of what you want them to do.
Right.
You know, I think that they have a mobile projector, but I think that the and screen that goes around, but if you're not tenured faculty, you don't get one of your own, so you have to sort of share and borrow it. And I think that having those rooms equipped with modern technology would be a good thing. Modern technology and ancient technology. So a chalkboard and projectors and screens would be good ideas. A lot of people now are using their computers for research. So they'll use it, right. Yeah. So having enough electrical cords and or outlets, and would those be just kind of basic things? I think that having sinks that work and all that. The spaces are fine. I don't see any need to have spaces. There is like a heating or air conditioning thing where the pipes talk to you. It whines, you know. It makes this crazy. It makes so this crazy true. Sound, you know. And it, you know, after it, it's disruptive for a while. And after a couple of weeks, you just sort of get used to it. And you just quit talking while it's making that noise.
You have to be respective of the pipes.
Yeah, you have to be respective of the pipes. So, right. I think in the drawing studio, certainly the storage would be an issue. And having in the figure drawing studio, having a place to store props would be a really good thing. And then in the other drawing studio, having some more furniture. Tables, drawing tables, and furniture would be necessary. I don't work in the older area of the building. You know, there's two sides to the building. There's the new side, and then the older mm-hmm. side. And the older side has some real issues, and I think that needs to be updated. Sort of like the heating, and the air conditioning. So that's sort of those sort of things, and then reconfiguring the rooms. And I think they need to spend some time thinking about remodeling some of those spaces to make them more usable, and right now they're not. You know, they're just like, they just took the wood shop and they moved it all down the sculpture area. Well, that room's empty.
Right.
So what are they going to do with it, you know? Okay. So I'm not sure, and there are a couple rooms there. Giving the graduate students on that back hallway a better, updating their heating and those spaces would be really a good thing.
Yeah.
But,
I agree with the graduate student one, especially if they actively chose BGSU and their art program, that should be something that should be taken into
consideration. Yeah, and I was just going to go there, so mm-hmm. I must have been reading your mind. It's like we are in competition to recruit students,
right?
And especially in the graduate program, and so we're looking for quality students, and so having a quality facility is really important. You know, it could change their mind whether they're going to go one place or another place. So,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And with the amount of art students that are probably visual learners, it sounds like the types of equipment you have in the classroom currently is not necessarily the most conducive to their learning.
No, I think that's right. And I like to spend most of my classes making stuff and doing things. I don't spend a lot of time lecturing. At least I don't think I do. So I'd much rather have you make things and do things. But when you do, you want to be able to write down, you know, on the wall to highlight something, or if you want to show a film or video, or show work examples of other people's work. We don't have that capability. We just can't just do it. You have to plan for it and way in advance, and sometimes that doesn't always work. So all the other. Rooms for teaching on campus have a, you know, technology now that's just part of the room, mm-hmm. and so we don't have that. So maybe having some of that technology without throwing away the old stuff, because we still need to be able to make a mess. You know, we still need to be able to make a mess. Yeah, we need to be able to draw and paint.
Right.
You know, stuff gets on the floor, and you know, so you still need to be able to do that. And need to have a place to clean your brushes and to wash your hands. So those things need to be a part of the.
All right. So we discussed a little bit about the equipment, the heating and air conditioning,
sure.
The sinks, some of the equipment. So thinking about all that together, what would if all of that were magically solved tomorrow, what would your dream classroom look like?
We think that the dream classroom has to be adaptable. So you need to be able to go, and not everything's, you know, the furniture is not nailed to the ground. Everything's on casters, it's able to move around, but it's solid. You could use it, you can work on it. So tables and chairs are movable. There are spaces on the wall, not only to hold critiques where you can put work on the wall, but also a place where you can write notes and write notes to support your lectures would be really helpful. So I think that would be it. You know, just having good storage for paintings, having a good storage for drawings. There's a different storage system for each one, having those in so students, when they're finished with their work, they can put it in a drawing rack. They don't have to haul it out, especially on rainy days, or if you're working with charcoal, it just gets everywhere and it's really, really dirty and dusty. Mm-hmm. So having those, I really do think that the model area where the models are and all that stuff needs to be, the infrastructure there is probably the one that's most lacking, and just having props that the models would interact with and helps.
Okay.
Help students learn how to draw those things would be really good. So if I were going to adjust anything, that would be probably what I would have, is have some sort of area where we could store that stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. But, you know, I think there's a lot of things that need to be. The problem with me is that I've only taught over there for 1 year, a full class schedule.
Really? Okay.
Because I've been the director of the Arts Village, which meant I caught a couple classes. I was over here in Chapman for 6 years as an instructor. Then I went to the Arts Village for 10 years. And last year was the only year that I've taught a full year in the School of Art. And this year I'm here. So, and I don't even teach over there now. I teach in a little classroom here.
Why'd they kick you out like that?
You know, that's what they did. They said, "Well, we don't want this guy around, so we need to hide him out." So,
I just
developed some other skills, and so we're doing learning community things, and so they said, "Hey, you, you know, we want some help with this. Would you help us?" And I said, "Sure." So that's why I'm here. So they didn't. I don't think it was a matter of kicking me out. I think it was just a matter of shifting me over somewhere. But yeah, I'm familiar with. I got my graduate degree at BGSU. So I went to undergrad in California in San Francisco, and then came here. And our system in San Francisco was pre-digital, so there wasn't all the digital stuff, and all there wasn't projectors and screens. If we wanted to show a film, we would bring in a projector and show it that way, but the spaces were about the same. The spaces were about the same, and it's like, I mean, you can only do so much to an art space, I think, to make it an art space.
Hi, my name is Anthony Smith, and I'm the supervising technician here at the School of Art at Bowling Green State University. I oversee all of the programs, their health and safety standards, practices, guidelines. Equipment from hand tools to major equipment throughout the programs, from sculpture to ceramics to glass, painting, printmaking, and pretty much anything that's happening in the building I'm a part of.
Is there anything specific about sculpture or woodwork that you've noticed has not met any of the standards so far, or anything that you would really like to change for safety reasons?
Well, the space itself is a fantastic space. We have over 9,000 square feet of space that's available for the students to use, and this past year we started an internal upgrade of cleaning. It just started off with a level of just housekeeping, just to get things, you know, up to a standard that we can practice all processes within the space. It was primarily used for stone carving and wood carving in the past, but we thought that there would be an opportunity for many more applications to be used in the space. So with just again, just stripping it down bare and just kind of starting over is what we decided to do, and then just started upgrading equipment a little bit by little bit, and how that can integrate itself within all the programs through the School of Art. So that was our goal in the beginning, and that's what we did last semester into this semester, and every day it presents a new challenge on what we're lacking, what else we still need, for each class that comes through. But to be a space that's integrated for the entire school is a challenge, because that many places are practicing that standard throughout the states and in our schools. So yeah, it's fun to do.
What would you say is the oldest piece of equipment?
The oldest piece of equipment I would say would be our kiln in the foundry, where we melt bronze, aluminum, and at times we would be involved with melting iron. And that was built in place when Sean Moran, the area head of sculpture, started working here 23 years ago, and he built it on site, so that would be our equipment that we have here.
Has there been any safety regulations changing over time with how old that piece of thing getting?
Well, primarily, I mean, within sculpture with metal casting, and to say the same thing within ceramics with fire and clay, that tradition, the way kilns are created, are thousands and thousands of years old. So not much has changed on the design. I mean, they're very similar. Now, when electricity is involved, gas is involved, yeah, there's always regulations and changes that are occurring, and there are definitely practices that we could evolve into for more contemporary, you know, times. So we do lack there, right? And there is most certainly modern day equipment that's available. It's just it takes time, it takes money,
right?
it takes the need too, right? So that's a tough class to fill every semester, or every other semester, because from 12 to 15 students being, you know, energized about casting metal, even sometimes you don't get that many. So that's a tough justification.
What's up, guys? Now that we've talked about some of the history of the Fine Arts Building and some 2D aspects and some 3D aspects and what we need to fix, I hope you've enjoyed our main points.
So now that we've talked to you, you should know about the different renovations and equipment that is needed to make this building perfect again.
I really hope you guys help me and my fellow artists out by spreading the word about our awesome cause. Leviosa!
Hey! Thank you for watching this lovely presentation. I hope you learned something. And to the person in the back, yeah, you, I saw you on your phone the whole time. I bet you didn't learn anything because you were on your phone. But all right.